Anastasia, you have introduced a very innovative area of research in the field of maternity and birth. Anastasia, what was the driving force, the inspiration that brought you to this field of research, which is quite innovative in the field of maternity and birth?
First of all, I would like to make it clear that in the field of midwifery or obstetric research, biomechanics or bioengineering has not to do only with thermography, but in general, in non-invasive techniques, and we mostly talking about non-invasive because you can't use something invasive in pregnant women. Thermography is just one field. For me personally, when I came in contact with the previous action, I saw that there are a big field for my discipline to be involved, because there are several open questions in which intra or cross-disciplinary collaboration can help. I'm totally engaged intra-disciplinary, because I think that the research development is so rapid, so scientists from different disciplines have to cooperate together to solve one problem, because nowadays problems are not belong in one discipline. So specifically regarding thermal imaging, it's not something invasive for us, because we used to use it in industry, mostly in buildings or in other applications, but it jumped from industry and military use to medical use almost 60 years ago. But someone maybe will hear, okay, it happened 60 years ago, why are we talking now about this? There is not one specific answer. First of all, one reason could be, again, the lack of cross-disciplinary collaboration. Another issue was that this technique since 2011 was really expensive, really, really expensive to use it just for research and see if it's valid or not. Secondly, just the last year, it took the first approval to be used in medicine, and mostly the first research studies are from the fields of cancer research, mostly for human breast cancer, and psychology. Already psychologists know that they can have more than 90% of accuracy in emotions like stress, fear, happiness, and other. But we decided to put it into maternity midwifery because it's an non-invasive imaging method which can give us real-time monitoring without any contraindication, contralimitation, and provide us objective data, not subjective, which we can use even every day. For example, in the future, maybe a pregnant woman can have one picture of herself, a selfie of her abdomen, every day. It has also the ability of video recording and everything. And it's probably the only method that can be used during labor, because really during labor, based on the knowledge I have, there is not even one method that can be used, especially to see the fetal movement. The open question we had solved is about fetal movement in correlation with mother's position. Does fetus change its position when the mother changes position, or it's vice versa, or they're correlated in a different way? And there's also another question, which is the best position to have a normal birth? Still, everything is based on experience, or subjective criteria. So we're trying to put more objective criteria and solve some issue, and let's say recreate midwifery to a more, not more scientific, it's already too much scientific, to a more visual reality science.
And what are the opportunities that you have discovered so far?
The opportunities regarding?
Regarding the field of midwifery, maternity.
Oh, it's a huge field. If someone will start, I think it's endless. I will use a joke. I think I will die and we will not finish just even the 5% of what we can do in this field, because we just started and really, really this field is huge, and a lot of engineers, I think, in the future will cooperate with midwives and obstetricians and nurses to solve several issues, because it's not only the fetus and the mother, it's also the midwife. We have really open questions about midwives as well.
Anastasia, you have just completed an SDSM project, and you have the opportunity to see something in correlation to what you are now saying, midwives in relationship with pregnant mothers. What did you really find?
We found that we need to analyze a little bit more of the data, but as a draft result, let's say that we found that midwifery consultation is not only a session that's happened, it has emotions, it has interaction. For example, we found different levels of emotion that midwife has during the session, how she interacts with the pregnant woman, when she's doing her pee, how she comes to her relaxed level or relief, as the midwives describe it. And we also found some differences, potential differences, between midwives with salutogenic orientation and not salutogenic orientation. For sure, we need further researchers with bigger sample to make it more correct, with more participants, to put more variables with which we can correlate all these findings. And as I told previously, it's really huge. It's also another field will just open, and we realize that, okay, it's not a hill, it's a mountain.
So you are pioneers, starting climbing the mountain.
I think we just make the first steps, and we don't really know yet which path to follow. Our first results must be which paths we need to follow, and then follow this path, and then make this path broad, so the next researchers could use this road to discover their mother.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome.